Hi all, electrical engineer Igor Ekimov is with you. Today we will look at modern current clamps with a DMC-100 multimeter from the FNIRSI company. Clamps can measure both direct and alternating current, accurate to hundredths of an ampere. In addition, they can measure current and voltage simultaneously, while showing power consumption. In multimeter mode, it measures voltage, resistance, capacitance, temperature, and also looks for phase and has a non-contact detection of the presence of alternating voltage. It can show graphs of changes in measured values. The internal memory of the device allows you to remember up to 30 measurements. The device is powered by an internal battery, which is a significant advantage. We'll talk about all this further in the video. If you are interested in other videos on electrics, then subscribe to the channel and press the bell. Special thanks for your likes and reposts. The device comes in such a beautiful package. The device can be given as a gift to people who are interested in technology, but it is not suitable for permanent storage of the device. On the back wall you can see what quantities it measures and the parameters of this device. We get the device. Here is the device itself. We take it out, turn it over. Here is the rest of the equipment. There are wires on top. We take them out of the package. The wires are standard, quite soft. According to the labels, they can withstand 1000 volts and 20 amps. The wires have plugs on the connectors and caps on the probes that protect them from corrosion. Remove the probe protection. The probes are quite sharp. They can easily pierce the insulation of a wire for measurements. The golden sheen is a coating that also protects them from oxidation. Here's your passport. It is in English and Chinese. In it you can see the characteristics of the device, and learn the rest from the video. This is a thermocouple, we'll talk about it a little later. And there is a charging cord with Type-C and USB connectors. To charge the device, this cord must be connected to any USB connector with a voltage of 5 volts. In the device, the cord is plugged in here. The device has a 3.7-volt battery with a capacity of 1500 mAh. There is also a button for connecting a flashlight. The current clamp is opened by this trigger by 25 mm. There is also a flashlight peephole. We turn on the button and the flashlight shines quite brightly and illuminates the place where the wire is inserted into the pliers. Turn it off. The device has a 2-inch high-definition color TFT display with a resolution of 240 by 320. The display is protected by a film that is easy to remove. The device is controlled by 5 buttons. The cords are connected from below. On the reverse side there are 6 self-tapping screws for disassembling the device. The device fits well in the hand. So it opens with the right hand, and so with the left. I would like to draw your attention to the compact size of the device, which makes it convenient to use. Here are the standard 266 pliers that I have been using for a long time. As you can see, our device is much smaller in size. And these are current clamps from GVDA, which I reviewed earlier. They are similar in size. I will leave a link to the review in the description. First, I will tell you how to use the device and what capabilities it has. And then we will test the device in practice. So let's turn it on. The device turns on the mode that I last used when turning it off. And it's convenient. If I usually use the device in dial-up mode, then when I turn it on, the device immediately switches to this mode. This device does not have an automatic mode for determining the type of measurements. This is good because I don't recommend using it. Quite a nice bright screen. Readings from different viewing angles are clearly visible. So I turned on the DC measurement mode. What do we see on the screen? The hold mode is listed first. This is freezing of values. The value is temporarily stored on the device screen. We hold it again and it turns off. Next flashlight icon. We activate the flashlight with this button. Our icon lit up, hold the button again and the flashlight turns off. Next, the battery charge level is shown. When the device arrived, it was fully charged. If the device is discharged, the icon turns red. Open the rubber plug and connect the device to a voltage of 5 volts. Below you can see which parameter is currently being measured. The value and units of measurement are shown below. In our case, these are amperes. The measuring range is determined automatically. It does not switch manually. The minimum and maximum values for the measurement session are shown below. Even lower is the scale for selecting parameters that we can measure with the device. We press the middle key, and we can switch the measurement parameters within the icon. We had direct current, now we have alternating current. We press again, we switch to the DC measurement mode. Using the left and right keys, we can switch icons. We hold the middle button for a long time. And we switch to the measurement mode with drawing a graph of the value. In this mode we can also switch parameters. We'll talk about this mode a little later. Long press the middle button to exit the mode. If we hold the right button for a long time, we switch to the mode of simultaneous measurement of voltage and current. The load power will be shown in the middle. The device detects direct or alternating voltage automatically. Hold this key again and exit the mode. Briefly press this key and save the value into the internal memory of the device. If you hold the key for a long time, you get into the device settings. On the first page we have remembered values. We see the last 6 values. To scroll through these values further, press the middle key. The page freezes and the icon turns orange. Now we can use the left and right buttons to scroll through this page. In total, the device remembers the last 30 values. Press this key again and exit the mode. Press the button to the right and get to the settings menu. We also press the middle key and we can adjust these settings. Use the left and right keys to select which setting we need to correct. Here is the language. We have English already selected. Let's switch gears. Select brightness control, and now we can regulate it. Let's go out. Let's look further. I have the measurement selected in degrees Celsius. Next, we can enable the auto shutdown timer. To do this, we choose what delay we will set and turn it on. I exit settings mode. Then restart and reset to factory settings. And here is the firmware version and manufacturer. Long press the key and exit the menu. Let's now test the device. First, let's check the current measurement. We connect the probes to a laboratory power source. We short circuit them. And we will operate the power source in the DC generation mode. I'm currently set to 10 amps. Let's apply current, and as you can see, we have 10 amps here, and here we have about 10 amps with an accuracy of 1%. Let's lower the current. Here's 9 amperes. 8. 7. 6. Here's 1 ampere. Ours shows 1.02 amperes, that is, an accuracy of 2%. If we show an error at the beginning, we reset the readings and turn on the current. And you see, it shows 0.99 amperes. Let's also check how the device draws a graph. Now we have entered the graph drawing mode, here we are. We raise, and as you can see, the device draws a graph of the current that passes through the clamps. Here we go up, here we go down. And as you can see, the maximum current that occurred during the measurement session is shown here. It's 5 amp. Minimum value 0 amp. Let's turn the clamps over. And as you can see, we already have minus 1 ampere. And our minimum value is minus 1 ampere. Exit the chart mode. The maximum current that the device measures is 100 amperes. It measures alternating current up to 600 amperes. The reading accuracy is 2.5%. Now let's switch the voltage measurement mode. By default, it measures DC voltage. Turn off the device for a while. We open the probes of the laboratory power supply. We connect the probes. Connect the red one to the input connector, and the black one to the COM connector. I connected the cords to a laboratory power source. Turn it on. As you can see, there are 12 volts here, and there are also 12 volts here, with an accuracy of 0.2%. We can regulate the voltage. Here is 2 volts. 3 volts. 10 volts. The readings of the laboratory power source and our mites differ by 0.2%. Let's see how hold works. We hold. Our hold is on fire. So we turn off the voltage supply. But the device still shows 10 volts. If we turn off hold, then our voltage becomes near zero. We turn on the device. We can also switch to value rendering mode. Here we have 10 volts. I can remember this value in the device's memory. We have it in the device's memory and display it here. I can also adjust the values. And as you can see, my adjustment is reflected in the graph. Let's exit this mode. The maximum constant voltage that the device measures is 1000 volts. Let's measure voltage and current at the same time. To do this, I will connect the light bulbs. So I put together a circuit. The current passes here through clamps. The probes of the device are connected directly to the power source. Now hold down the right key and switch to the mode of simultaneous measurement of voltage and current. Apply voltage. Our lights came on. As you can see, the voltage and current are approximately the same. The clamp shows 29.53 watts. And the laboratory power supply shows approximately the same thing. Please note that the clamps themselves chose the DC current measurement mode. Here we can adjust the voltage. If you apply more voltage, the power consumption increases. As you can see, the readings from the laboratory power supply and the clamps are approximately the same. Selected voltage icon. Use this button to select alternating voltage. The fact that the voltage is now different from zero is not a defect. These are pickups from the probes of the device. If we short-circuit the probes, our readings will be reset to zero. The device measures the RMS value of alternating voltage up to 750 volts. Let's now measure the voltage at the outlet. We measure. As you can see, my outlet has 225 volts. To determine where the phase is in the socket, turn off the black probe and turn on the phase detection mode. Here we define it. Here we get zero. Our device does not respond. And here we have a phase. The device emits a signal. If we switch, our NCV mode turns on. Here we have an electric field sensor. When we bring it to the socket, it lights up red and a rapid beep is emitted. Let's switch to resistance measurement mode, measuring range from 0.1 ohm to 100 mohm. Let's measure a resistance of 10 ohm. Here it shows 99.95 ohm. This is only 0.5% less than face value. The resistor itself may have such an error. Press the middle key and go to dialing mode. In the dialing mode, a signal sounds when the resistance between the probes is less than 50 ohms. The response speed is quite good. At the same time, the device shows the resistance of the circuit. Press again and go to diode testing mode. The blue LED has the highest forward voltage, so let's check it. Let's connect. Here our LED lights up, and its forward voltage is 2.6 volts. Turn it over, OL, infinity. Thus, we can measure the forward voltage on the diode and check its pinout. Press the button again and go to the capacity measurement mode. The device allows you to measure capacitances from 1 picofarad to 100,000 microfarads. Now let's check a capacitor with a nominal value of 330 nanofarads. Before checking capacitors, they should be discharged. This can be done by shorting the terminals if the energy in the capacitor is negligible. Let's connect. Here we have a device that shows 331 nanofarads. This is approximately the same as the nominal value. Let's check a 47 microfarad electrolytic capacitor. We close the conclusions. We connect, taking into account the polarity. Here the device showed 47 microfarads. The next parameter is frequency measurement. I will not dwell on it in detail. This mode is rarely used. So I touch the measuring probe, and the device shows 50 Hz. This is the frequency of interference to the probes of the device, which corresponds to the frequency of the supply network. The device displays this frequency correctly. Press the middle key and get into the temperature measurement mode in Celsius. By default, it measures the temperature with a sensor inside the device. It shows a temperature of 31 degrees. This temperature is usually a little high, as it heats up the board inside the device. Therefore, it is better to connect an external sensor. Temperature can be measured from -55 to 1300 degrees. Let's connect the thermocouple. Here I have connected it. Let's take the temperature of my fingers. It showed me 39 degrees. This is a little higher than the real one by about 2 degrees. That is, we must make an adjustment of 2 degrees when measuring. So I turned on the AC current measurement, and the device shows the current going to the apartment. Now we can turn on the flashlight. As you can see, it lights up quite brightly here. Turn off the flashlight. To measure the power that goes into the apartment, you need to connect the probes. Here I am measuring the current of the circuit, here I am measuring the voltage. And now my device shows 227 volts and about 1 ampere. In the middle it shows the power consumption, about 240 W. As you can see, the device itself determined that there is alternating voltage. Let's see how the NCV function works. As you can see, the device is far from the shield. And it shows that the field is minimal and shows it in blue. We're getting closer. When the field strength is average, the device already blinks yellow. We are still getting closer. And it shows in red. We're leaving. And, as you can see, there is no field here anymore. Using the device, you can determine whether there is alternating voltage in the boxes or in the switchboard before doing work on it. Sometimes this device can be used to find wiring under a small layer of plaster. But it is better to use specialized devices for this. This is such an interesting and compact device with great capabilities. I'm glad I got it. It can be useful for repairing wiring in the house and car. I have already described all its advantages in the video, so I will not repeat myself. If you have any questions, ask them in the comments. I left a link to the device in the description. Write your opinion about this device in the comments. Share the video with those who may be interested in this device. Subscribe to the channel and press the bell so you don't miss new videos. Like, and see you in new and old videos.